My favourite colour. That probably changes quite a bit, but I suppose black is a preeminent colour that's sort of been a part of my life since the early days. Trying to define inspiration is tricky because it comes from so many places. I mean, it comes from everyday life, it comes from things you read, it comes from everything you see. You sort of draw an awful lot of things. It comes from history, you know. Everything around you inspires you in some way. Design and music were massive inspirations. I always wanted to try and design record covers. And I started out by, whenever I got a single that didn't have a cover on it that I bought, a 7-inch single, I made a cover for it. And that's when I started doing all those kind of things. The U2 covers, Unforgettable Fire, and the Joshua Tree are kind of slightly linked in the way that they look. And I think the inspiration was, when we initially set out to do the cover, the working title was The Two Americas. And what the band were interested in finding was places in an industrialized nation that have sort of met the desert and that whole feel of where nature and industrialization kind of meet and are inspired to sort of create things. Working with Anton Corbijn, who is, you know, such a great photographer. My role with him is, in a sense, we work together and as a bouncing board and just following what's going on, making sure that we're covering all the aspects of what we possibly need to produce a cover. Even though sometimes you set out with a particular idea in mind, what you end up with might be totally different from what you started out with, because sometimes something that happens almost by accident at a shoot is inspiring. Anton had gone out 2 weeks ahead of everybody else to look at locations, and we went to a place in Nevada called Bodie, which is a national monument, which is a ghost town, which was abandoned in the 1920s, a mining town. And it was absolutely fantastic, inspiring place. But we also shot in a lot of other places. What we'd done is we'd flown up to Reno and hired a coach and driven back through Death Valley and all those kind of areas back towards Los Angeles. And we were very open as we drove along, whatever took our fancy. We were in the coach on the day, we were sort of heading from one place to the other, and then Anton in the back of the coach suddenly shouts, stop the coach, and we all sort of didn't know what was going on. And Anton says, there's a tree over there, and which was, he saw this one tree in the distance on the flat plains, where normally Joshua trees tend to grow in groups. And we sort of got out of the coach and we sort of all went across there. And this was very early in the morning, it was very cold. We traveled across to this particular area, and so halfway across the bush, as we walked across, the coach driver said, look, watch out for rattlesnakes. And so everybody sort of just suddenly froze. But he said, it's okay, this time in the morning, they'll be asleep. So we went and we did the shot there, which was the inside cover shot. It was such an iconic looking element. And of course, being cold, the band were saying, well, Bono especially said, this is going to come out in the summer. We kind of need to look like we're here in the middle of the heat. So take your jackets off and things like that. And sort of the guys did it, although it was an extremely cold day. But the actual cover shot was photographed at a Zabriskie Point, which was a sort of, you can see, it's almost lunar in its look. So we sort of stopped there and just wandered around the place, just shooting as we went. And that's where the cover image came from. I wanted to portray that cinematic type of feel. So that's why the widescreen effect was used. Pushing to that one side, when you had all that space, seemed to, in some ways, show them in that landscape, let the landscape speak for itself, and the band are just part of this particular, you know, landscape. The music itself, you know, has that sort of evangelical feel. You know, this is the band taking on America in its own terms. And I think the music is there's so many great tracks on that album that, you know, it really was an inspiring time for everybody. It just uses sort of black and gold as the two colours that were there. The gold is symbolic of the whole discovery of America. A very simple, expanded typeface. The use of the gatefold was good and interesting because it actually had this great shot on the inside, and on the back has the picture of the tree with the guy standing in front of it. So it worked really, really well for what it is, and seems to have become a lot of people's favourite U2 album cover. Inspiration is endless, and it comes from every form you can possibly imagine. The main thing is to remain open to those inspirations, to not close your mind down. Inspiration is going to come from every angle, and you have to make sure you're open enough to capture that inspiration as it comes.